So now we need to look at the integrated rate law for the second order kinetics and zeroth order kinetics. We looked at first order kinetics first because it is most prevalent. But now let's look at second and zeroth. Second order first. Okay, so let's work our way through the equation to begin with. We know that we're dealing with the same reaction equation. A goes to products. Things that we know about it is, since the coefficient is 1 in this case, we have rate looking like this. Since it's second order, we have the rate law looking like this. We set them equal to each other, okay? And when we take the integration of that, and you might want to, again, if you've had calculus, it helps you remember the equations for me by going through the integration. But once you set them equal to each other and you integrate, you end up with this equation. And this is what the second order equation looks like that relates time and concentration. Remember, these integrated rate laws are always in terms of time and concentration, whereas our plain old ordinary rate laws are rates and rates and concentrations, not time. All right, so that is our second order equation. Now, between the top one and the second one, they're the same equation, and you could learn it either way you want to learn it. All I've done is a little bit of rearranging. I did the rearranging again so that we have our linear relationship, okay? It's in the slope-intercept form of a line. So this tells me that if I would plot y along the y-axis, 1 over concentration, and I plot along the x-axis, the time, which we always do, then I have a straight line and I get the slope out of this equation. All right, so plot of this versus time gives you a straight line if it's second order. And that's one way we can determine the order. We can plot natural log versus concentration. Okay, and if that's a straight line, then it's first order. If it's not a straight line, we can try 1 over concentration versus time. If that's a straight line, then it's second order. If that's not a straight line, then it's not second order, okay? But let's say we plotted this and it was a straight line. My question for you is, what will the slope be equal to of that graph? Well, if you can read what y equals mx plus b in the matchup of m, you're going to get, in this case, the slope won't pop out for you is going to be the value of the rate constant k. So let's do a similar work that we did with first order kinetics with our half-life, okay? Half-life is when the time it is when your concentration is half your initial concentration. So we'll go up to that original equation up there, and where you see just the A, we're going to replace it with A naught divided by 2. And we replace it by A naught divided by 2, there it is, I've just done the substitution there. I'm going to combine the A naught terms, and I'm going to solve for the half-life. And that's going to give me this half-life equation here. If you look at this half-life equation, you'll notice that concentration does affect the half-life. It is not a constant chunk of time that cuts it in half. And as the concentration gets smaller and smaller, you're putting a smaller number in the denominator, your half-life is going to get longer and longer. So it takes longer if the concentration is low to cut it in half than it will cut it in half if the concentration is big. And that is what you will see that indicates it's a second order versus a first order, is if the concentration affects the half-life. Now we're not going to look at it and plot it out, but that is the half-life equation for that. All right, let's just mention a zeroth order reaction, okay? If it's zeroth order, A is raised to the zero power, which tells me that the rate is a constant. It runs at a constant rate. If it runs at a constant rate, then we would have, all right, if we plotted rate, okay, rate versus concentration, the rate doesn't change with concentration. We have a nice straight line like that. That's rate is a constant, okay? But if you were to plot concentration versus time, and not rate versus, I mean, you know, this is rate versus concentration. Let's do concentration versus time. Concentration is going to drop linearly with time, and that's how you would get your straight line for that, okay? A plot of rate versus time looks like rate versus time. Well, rate versus time would look like this as well, because rate is a constant. It's not going to change how fast it's running, no matter what, okay? It's always that value. All right, so we've seen in this lesson what the equation is for second order kinetics, what the graph looks like for second order, what the half-life equation is for second order, and a brief mention about what zeroth order is going to look like. What we're going to do in our next video is just do a summary of all three of those kind of put next to each other.